Hello everyone. Today I'm going to start chapter 9, areas of parallelogram and triangles, and some theorem I'm going to write. Areas of parallelogram and triangles. It is our topic today, and I am going to teach this topic. Students, 2-3 theorems I given. Okay, if you have completed that theorem, then you can solve the question of exercise 9. And today I am going to teach some theorem related to your exercise. That theorem I'm going to teach, theorem 5 is a student, a diagonal of a parallelogram divides it into two triangles of equal area. This is our topic. This is our theorem. Okay. There is one theorem. The name of theorem is a diagonal of a parallelogram divides it into two triangles of equal area. Okay, it is our theorem, and we have to find that diagonal is dividing into equal area of a parallelogram. Means that, actually, student, answer is hidden in question. Okay, question is saying that suppose that you have one parallelogram, when we are going to divide in two equal parts, then this diagonal is dividing in two equal area. Their area and their area will be equal. We have to prove it. Okay, how we will prove their area and their area will be equal? Okay, let me see. Given given one second given a parallelogram just construct a figure. The name is A, B, C, and D. Okay. Just try to construct one diagonal also. Okay. We know that in parallelogram, this side is equal to that side, and this side is equal to that is parallel to that side. Okay. Given a parallelogram ABCD, it is a parallelogram. Okay, in which BD is a diagonal where in this parallelogram BD is a diagonal BD is a diagonal of a parallelogram. It is a parallelogram. In this parallelogram, BD is a diagonal. We can construct another diagonal also. Okay, we can construct like this types of figure. We can construct, no problem. Okay, then we will prove this area will be equal to that area. Okay. Then we have to prove. We have to prove their area is equal to that area. Okay, means that area is written in subform in the small. Area of triangle ABD is equal to area of triangle. What we started from here, no? Then we will start from there. CDB. I started from ABD, then CBD. Okay, their area is equal to that area. We have to prove in this theorem. Then, now I'm going to write proof part. What is proof of this question? Okay, in triangle. In triangle ABD, okay student, ABD, and in which triangle? In triangle ABD and which triangle? In triangle CBD. In triangle CBD, there are two triangles in this parallelogram, right? In triangle ABD, this triangle and in that triangle. Okay. We know that. What? If we will construct this triangle, then it will be like this. It is not right angle. ABD. Okay. Here D C B, this side is equal to that side, right? And this side is equal to that side. Understand? Then we have AB equal to CD. Okay, AB equal to what? CD. How it is equal? Because opposite sides of parallelogram equal. Here we are looking. Opposite sides are equal. Okay, because opposite sides are equal. Of parallelogram we can write, no problem, we can write. Okay, and AD equal to CB also. AD equal to CB. AD equal to CB, right? Opposite sides are equal of parallelogram. Okay, straight. Opposite sides are equal of a parallelogram. That's why AB equal to CD and AD equal to CB. Okay. And which side is not equal? That means it is common. Diagonal is common in itself. If we will divide this parallelogram into two equal parts of a triangle, then we will get like this figure. We will get this types of figure. We will get means that BD and BD. Okay. BD and BD is here. Means that what? BD and BD is a common in itself. Understood? BD is equal to, we can write BD also. BD and DB, whatever. BD equal to BD, it is common. Common in itself. Understand, student? Common in itself. Means that, student, we are looking here. Sides are equal. Sides are equal. So by the which criteria both triangle will be equal with the criteria of side criteria, it will be equal. That means triangle ABD and triangle CBD will be congruent in each other, right? Therefore, we will write triangle ABD is congruent to triangle CBD. But how it is congruent? By which criteria? By which criteria, students? By triple S criteria. Okay. Understand? By side criteria, this triangle is congruent to that triangle. Means that we can say that in this question, we can say that hence area of this triangle is equal to that triangle. ABD is equal to area of triangle CBD. It is the our proof of this question. Okay, don't forget it. Try to write two times of this theorem, then automatically you will get. Understand? Now, student, I'm going to write another theorem. Firstly, we will understand simple theorem. Then we will start hard theorem. Theorem 6 is prove that area of a triangle is equal to 1 by 2 into base into height. Okay, we have to prove the area of triangle base into height. How we will prove? Okay, students, write down given things, don't forget. You have to write given. Firstly, we will construct a triangle. I will construct. Okay, the name is A, B and C. Okay, given a triangle ABC in which BC is the base and L. Oh, sorry, not there. Firstly, we will write one perpendicular line. We will get perpendicular. Their name is AL. Okay, and AL is the perpendicular. That means corresponding height. Then we have to prove. What we have to prove? Area of triangle
ABC is equal to 1 by 2 into base into height. Base into height, we have to choose. Okay. And one more triangle we will construct. Okay. Parallel to BC, we will construct one line, and parallel to AB, we will construct a line. Okay, students, and their name we will write their name D. Okay. Construction is B extend AD parallel to BC and CD parallel to AB in this direction we extend. Okay, students, we can write and we can leave it out also. Okay. Then in this figure we are looking here, AL is a perpendicular and BC is a base. Okay, and AL is the height. Okay, but in this figure AB is parallel to CD and BC is parallel to AD. Understand? We will write AD construction work. We will write construction work. We will write AD parallel to BC and AD parallel to DC. Right? Then we have to prove. Then we have to prove AB parallel to BC and CD parallel to BA. We have to prove. Okay. Here, students, BCDA is a parallelogram. I mean, parallelogram whose diagonal is what? AC. Okay. And what is the function of AC? AC divides it into two triangles, same as previous theorem, two triangles of equal areas. Okay, just think about previous theorem, same process we will do here. Okay, means that, students, if that will divide into two equal parts, therefore area of triangle ABC is equal to 1 by 2 into area of parallelogram BCDA. Okay, and it will equal to what? 1 by 2 into BC. BC means base and AL means height. Okay, means we will write, therefore area of triangle is equal to 1 by 2 into base into height. Okay, how we get here BC and AL in parallelogram BCDA? Since area of parallelogram is equal to base into height. The area of parallelogram is base into height, that's why it will be BC into AL base into height. We prove it. Okay, this is our required proof. Okay, we can write in words. This is required proof of a triangle. Okay, this is the required proof of a triangle whose area is base into height by 2. That means 1 by 2 into base into height. Students, it is the very simple. Okay, tomorrow I will start some hard theorem, and you have to complete these two theorems at the home and try to complete. Don't forget it. Okay.